Leah here from Leah4sci.com/MCAT, and in this video, I'll take you through velocity and speed as it comes up in MCAT Translational Motion. You can catch my entire series on translational motion by visiting my website, Leah4sci.com/MCAT Physics. On the MCAT, speed and velocity may be used to represent the same concept, but there is a difference and it's important that you understand. In a previous video, I talked about how speed is a scalar, meaning it has only a magnitude, but velocity is a vector given that it has a magnitude and a direction. As an example, I can say I ran 5 miles per hour, that's my speed, or I ran 5 miles per hour northwest, given that I have the direction, that makes it a velocity. The formula for speed and velocity are very similar, but they actually mean something completely different. We'll use S for speed, and speed is equal to distance over time. Velocity is a vector, so in physics you were taught to put an arrow over the V. On the MCAT, we'll just assume that we know it's a vector. And the formula is displacement over time, which you'll see written as delta x over delta t. Anytime you see this triangle in an equation, the triangle stands for delta, and it means the difference, or simply final minus initial. The delta x means x final minus x initial, and delta t is t final minus t initial. In other words, we're finding the total displacement or the total change in distance over the total change in time. And since velocity is a vector, velocity will be in the direction of the displacement. Depending on what you're using as a study guide, you may see the formula written in very different ways, but don't let it throw you off. As you're studying, instead of just memorizing, make sure you're comfortable with the units and comfortable manipulating them so that you can solve for the equation in any format. So let's play with this a little more. We'll change our delta t to be just a time. We want to keep delta x instead of just x because you may start from a non-zero starting point, so you'll have to use your x initial and x final. We have v instead of delta v because we're assuming that we have a constant average velocity. If you have to find the average between a and b, you simply write a plus b over 2, and that's your average. For the average velocity, we have v1 plus v2 over 2, and that'll give us v average, or simply v as we use it in the expression. But now let's say you're asked to solve for x. Anytime you're told just x, assume it's your x final. The first thing we want to do is rewrite or understand the equation in a format that gives us x, and that'll give us the following. V is equal to x final minus x initial over t, and then we'll solve for x final algebraically. First thing we want to do, following PEMDAS, remember you have parentheses, exponents, multiplication, division, addition, and subtraction. We're dividing by t, so we want to move that to the other side by multiplying both sides by t. Let's rewrite it so it's clear. Vt is equal to x final minus x initial. We have minus x initial, so we want to bring that to the other side, plus x initial on both sides. And that gives us our final equation for x final, or simply x, is equal to x initial plus vt. This is the format that I learned in physics and the one I'm most comfortable with. If x initial is 0, then your formula is simply x is equal to vt, where v is the average or the constant velocity. Let's try this once more, solving for time. The first thing we have to do is get time out of the denominator because you need to have your unknown as a standalone unit. So we bring it up to the numerator, once again multiplying both sides by t. But this time, we divide both sides by v to isolate t. This gives us t by itself is equal to delta x divided by v. For a complete list of MCAT kinematic equations, including my guide for how to know which formula to use and when, visit my website, Leah4sci.com/MCATphysics. Look for the cheat sheet under translational motion. Let's end with a practice question. Find the speed and velocity if a girl walks 1.4 miles in 20 minutes to reach a friend's house. The homes are exactly 0.7 miles apart. The reason there are two distances given is because if the two homes are exactly 0.7 miles, it doesn't mean that you only walk 0.7 miles to get there. Say there are streets, avenues, or general obstacles in the way, you may find yourself taking a path that looks like this for a total of 1.4 miles, even though the map says 0.7 miles. This is where you get to see the clear distinction between speed and velocity. Remember, the formula for speed is actual distance over time. The actual distance walked is 1.4 miles, and the time is 20 minutes. So let's solve in miles per minute. We have 1.4 over 20. If we try to do long division on the MCAT, it takes too long. Instead, we'll use the trick of multiplying the top and bottom by 10, moving the decimal one space to the right. This gives us 14 over 200. If you're not comfortable with this trick, go back to my math series on my website at leah4sci.com/mcatmath. I got rid of the decimal, making it slightly easier, but 14 over 200 is still too difficult. I'm looking for a number that I can divide out of both of them to make it simpler. 14 and 200 both divide by 2. 14 divided by 2 is 7, 200 by 2 is 100. 7 over 100 is a number divided by some factor of 10, which lets us use my other trick of moving the decimal space back. If I have two zeros, I divide by moving the decimal two spaces back, and that gives me 0.07 miles per minute. This is the speed. Now let's look for the velocity. Remember that velocity is equal to delta x over t, or the total displacement. Even though the girl walked 1.4 miles, the actual displacement, or as the crow flies, is just 0.7 miles. And so this equation is written out as 0.7 miles over 20 minutes. Now the delta x would be x final minus x initial. X final is 0.7, x initial is 0, which is why we used just 0.7. If we didn't start out at 0, we would have a different delta x value, so definitely keep that in mind. One more time, we'll move the decimal to the right for the top and bottom to get rid of that decimal. This gives me 7 over 200. Again, something that would take too long to calculate by long division, so we can try two different tricks. The first trick we can use is estimation. Remember, on the MCAT, close enough is good enough. 7 over 200 is pretty close to 7 over 210. 7 and 210 both divide by 7. 7 divided by 7 is 1. 21 by 7 is 3, and now we have 1 over 30. We can estimate this further. 1 over 30 is equal to 1 over 3 times 1 over 10. You should be familiar with the decimal values of common fractions. 1 over 3 is 0.33. 0.33 times 1 over 10, or simply divided by 10, move the decimal back one space, and that is equal to 0.033 miles per minute. This trick usually saves time. Here I found it to be a little too long, so we'll try another trick. If we look at 7 over 200, ideally, any number divided by 100 is very easy to memorize because we have 1 followed by zeros. To get 200 to 100, we have to divide by 2, and so we divide 7 by 2 as well. This is not as simple, but if you think about it, half of 7 is 3.5. Half of 6 is 3, and we have 1 left over. Half of 1 is a half, and that gives us our 3.5. 3.5 over 100 is much easier to work with. We're dividing by a factor of 10 with two zeros. We move the decimal back two spaces, and that gives us 0.035, which is very close to 0.33. Use whichever trick feels more natural to you, but whatever you do, do not resort to long division. It's going to take too much time. Be sure to join me in the next translational motion video, where I talk about acceleration as it relates to MCAT kinematics. Are you stuck on a specific MCAT topic? I offer private online tutoring where I focus on your needs to strengthen your individual weaknesses. Tutoring details can be found using the link below or by visiting my website, leah4sci.com/mcattutor. Are you overwhelmed by the sheer volume of information required for the MCAT? Are you worried that lack of a proper study plan and low MCAT score will prevent you from getting into medical school? My new ebook, The MCAT Exam Strategy, a 6-week guide to crushing the MCAT, will help you formulate a concrete study plan by helping you figure out where you stand now, identify your goals, and figure out what it takes to reach them. And it's yours free when you sign up for my email newsletter at mcatexamstrategy.com. By signing up for my email newsletter, you'll also be the first to know when I have new videos, MCAT study guides, cheat sheets, tips, and so much more. The link again, mcatexamstrategy.com.